RAWGraph is an open source online tool maintained by Density Design Lab in Politecnico di Milano and Studio Calibro for easily creating static visualization of data that you can download and open up in vector editing software such as Adobe Illustrator. To start running it, you need to click on Use it now and the main page will appear. The first step is to choose a dataset. The empty space that you see here is the place where the chosen dataset will be displayed. You can copy and paste in the white window your data table from other applications such as Microsoft Excel or Google Spreadsheet or other formats like as CSV or JSON. You can copy and paste an URL that matches an online dataset, or you can try one of the sample datasets made available for you. There are 10 sample datasets available that allows you to create views and experiment with different visual models. The first one is a dataset coming from IMDb databases describing movie statistics. If you click on it, the dataset will appear in the white window. If the button becomes green, it means that the dataset has been successfully parsed. You can now scroll down and look at the visual models option that RAWGraph offers. Some of them are used to display dispersions, hierarchies, or time-based data, but we will look in detail at the visual models in the next lesson. Indeed, choosing a model is not always a simple task. You need to know the dataset and what you want to show. In this case, each row describes a movie row, and each column is a characteristic such as the budget, the box office, the genre, and so on. For instance, if you want to show whether the most appreciated movies by critics and audiences are those with a high budget, you can try using a dispersion graph such as a scatterplot, which is one of the easiest ways to display values for two variables for a set of data. By choosing the scatterplot, an info box giving further information about the visual model will appear. Once you have chosen the visual model, you can scroll down and access the next step concerning the mapping of dimensions that you want to display on your scatterplot. Green buttons correspond to the column of your dataset, while white boxes coincide with visual variables. For assigning a dimension to a visual variable, you can easily drag and drop the green buttons into the white windows. Since the goal of the scatterplot is to show the relationship between two quantitative values, you should assign the X and Y axis the dimension you want to correlate. Not all sizes can be associated with all variables, so RAWGraphs suggest the types of size that each variable can handle. For example, on a Cartesian axis, you can only map numbers and dates. Indeed, if you try to drag and drop a string such as the genre column on the x-axis, white window, the bottom will become yellow, suggesting that you can't map that size to that variable. For visualizing if the most appreciated movies by critics and audiences are those with a high budget, you can put on the x-axis the budget. And so far, nothing is happening because you need one more dimension. And the y-axis on the rating on IMDb. Once the first two dimensions have been mapped, the scatterplot will appear in the section below dedicated to the customization of your visualization, where a first preliminary visualization displays data points or movies in the Cartesian space. Each circle corresponds to a movie, but it's hard to read the visualization without the titles of each movie displayed. Following the same procedure as before, you can associate the movie column where the titles are shown to the labels variable. Now you can see that, for example, ET has a very high rating and a low production budget, as well as Raiders of the Lost Ark. And that, with the exception of the Twilight Saga, New Moon and Zookeeper, all other movies are in a medium-high area of the ranking, although production costs vary. This visual model allows you to map a dimension on the size variable. For instance, by dragging and dropping the box office column, you can see the box office revenue of each movie mapped to the size of each circle. By coming back to the area dedicated to visualization, we can see that despite the fact that many tickets were purchased for the Twilight Saga New Moon, it was not appreciated at all. The scatterplot allows also to assign a color to circles. Let's try, for instance, the genre column. There are no obvious correlations with the genre, except for the fact that, among the selection of movies shown, the dramatic ones tend to have a lower production budget than the action ones. Once you are satisfied with the dimension mapped, you can customize the visualization modifying the given parameters. You can play with the size of each visualization by changing the length and the height of the arbor, making it larger and higher in order to better fit in your presentation or publication. Moreover, you can increase or decrease the left margin, giving more room to labels, and you can also change the maximum size of circles without affecting the readability of the visualization. Then, by setting the origin at 0,0, value will start from 0 both on X and Y axis, instead of from the lowest value. Finally, you can edit colors by both typing the hexadecimal code or using the color picker. Once you are satisfied with your visualization, you just have to export the visualization. You can export PNG raster images, SVG vectors, or a JSON file. If you want, you can also copy and paste a snippet in your HTML code to embed the visualization. In this lesson, you learn how to design and download a scatterplot, which is a dispersion visual model, on RAWGraphs.